In this illustration, we'll be discussing about the conduction in a medium of varying thermal conductivity. We are given that a rod of length L with thermally insulated surface and area A is made up of a material whose thermal conduction varies as K as alpha by T, where alpha is a constant and T is the body temperature. The ends of rod are maintained at temperature T1 and T2. We are required to find the rate of heat flow in this rod and temperature of rod as a function of x, the distance from low temperature n. So here in analysis, if we draw the situation where we are given that this is a rod in which if temperature of one end is T1, other is T2, where it is given that T2 is greater than T1, so heat will be flowing from high temperature end to low temperature end. And from low temperature end at a distance x, if we consider an elemental section of width dx, then we can see on one side if temperature is T, on the other side it will be T plus dT. So we can first calculate the rate of thermal conduction here is, this we can write as dq by dt, which remains constant. And for this element we can write, here we can also write rate of thermal conduction here is for element. This will be kA dt by dx. If we substitute the value of k, which is also varying here, this will be alpha A by T multiplied by dt by dx. And throughout the rod, this value must remain C, which we are writing as a constant, because we assume the steady state of thermal conduction throughout the rod. Now, in this situation, we can write this as dq by dt dx. We can also write this C. So, the C dx is equals to alpha A by T multiplied by dt. Here, if we integrate it, x we can integrate it from 0 to L for the length of the rod and temperature are varying from T1 to T2. And this relation gives us ln of T within limits from T1 to T2 is equals to CL by alpha A. So here, this giving us the value of C as alpha A upon L multiplied by ln of T2 by T1. That is the rate of flow of heat. This is one result of the problem. We are required to find the rate of flow of heat in this rod. We are also required to find the temperature of rod as a function of x. And for the same relation, we can reintegrate it. Here we can write C dx is equals to alpha A dt by T. If we again integrate it at x equals to 0, the temperature was T1 and at a distance x, temperature is T as a function of x. Then on integrating this, it is giving us ln of T within limits from T1 to Tx is equals to, again we are getting it as C, and this will be x upon alpha A. And further, if we substitute the limits, this will give us ln of Tx divided by T1 is equals to x upon alpha A, and the value of C we can substitute, which we already calculated. That is equals to alpha A by L ln of T2 by T1. From here, you can directly get the value of Tx, which we are required to find. And the value of Tx here is, here this log on both sides can be eliminated as here alpha A gets cancelled out. So this Tx we are getting is equals to T1 multiplied by T2 by T1 to power x by L. That is the result of this problem.